In the second part to the shape and grain section of the brush creator, we're going to be looking at the grain section. We're going to start with everything set in the stretched section here. Not all of these work in follow and tiled. Also inside of the paint category here, we have all the settings inside of canvas texture influence turned all the way to their lowest setting, so that we don't have any other factors influencing what we see on the screen. So let's start with grain smoothing. So here, if we draw on the screen with grain smoothing turned on and then we turn it off, what we're going to see is these edges up here have been smoothed and anti-aliased. These ones down here have not. And so you're going to see a little bit rougher grain when you're using this turned off. Now DPI here, and what you can see is this grain right here I'm using because it really will help make apparent that there's a pattern here. There's an up, down, left, and right arrow key and a little square right in the center. Then shift, control, alt, and a checkbox. So when we see this tile, we can recognize which parts are in which areas. All right, so this we have set at a scale of 100. And now the DPI, if we change the scale of the document, let's say we go from 200 to 400. You'll notice this little square in the center and this little square right here, these are the same size. Now, the DPI of the canvas has changed, but the DPI of the grain right here has stayed the same. If we turn DPI off, then when we start to paint again, you can see that this has gone back to the same size right here, but adjusted for the DPI of the canvas, meaning you have a bigger canvas and the brush size stays the same. Then when you move to the other one, it will be similar, but the brush size is smaller because the canvas is bigger. All right, so let's bring our canvas size back to 200. And when we turn DPI off, it's going to reset, and back on, it's going to start again from where we are now. So it'll hold the last DPI state. So over here, if we had this set at 400, when this was checked, it will remember 400. If we uncheck it, change this to 200, check it again, it's going to check this DPI setting first and then apply it. So if you see some different behavior here, that's what it's doing, is checking what the current state is when the box was checked. All right, so let's leave that there. Let's go ahead and clear this. So let's look at random start offset. Random start angle is going to be the same thing. Start, what this means, let's go ahead and put some these, every single one of these combinations here, the source, these are called splats. So let's put some more splats here on the screen. And when we check random start offset, when we start, each time we put the pen tip down, it's called a start. This is going to adjust where it starts on this whole pattern right here in grain. Same thing with the angle. Random splat offset, let's turn this off and this on. The splat, again, is each one of these. That means that every single one of these will be a random starting position on this grain. Follow shape size means that if we have this adjusting with pressure, so let's go back over here to stroke, and let's turn pen pressure so it adjusts here, that this will adjust its size smaller when the tip is smaller and larger when the brush size is larger. Angle jitter, again, like random start angle, angle jitter is going to be like this one right here, random splat offset. Every single splat, every time we put an image on the screen, it's going to be a slightly different angle. Now follow shape rotation. If I turn my stylus as I'm drawing, this won't do anything because we have rotation up here in shape. We have this turned off. So we can't follow something that's not happening. So here, now when we start and we turn the stylus, you're going to see that this shape is moving along with us. Now follow is going to make this stay with this like there was a nail through the one holding it into position every single time that we put something on the screen. Let's go ahead and close shape. Tiled is going to take that pin out. That means that as we paint, we're just revealing what's already underneath. Stretched is in between. Again, when we have this all the way to the right to 100%, it's going to be just like follow. When we have this all the way to the left, it's going to be just like tiled. You can see that right here, just like tiled. In the middle, it's going to be playing a little bit of catch up. So you can see that it's just dragging, it's dragging this grain behind us. The grain is following the shape, but it's not pinned directly to it. All right, so now that we understand what these different parts do, let's go ahead and change this spacing jitter from 100 back to something useful. So now let's look at stretched, set at 0. Let's put it here at 20%. You can see that it's getting this grain to follow along with us. Let's put it at 50. At 75. Let's put this all the way up at 100. In the next video, we're going to be looking here at the paint category, and we'll go through all of these. If you have any questions or comments about how to use the shape and grain section of the brush creator, please put it in the comment section. Until next time, stay creative and have a wonderful day.